Trust it.
Hey everybody, Dr. O here. In this short video, we're just going to talk about the layers of connective tissue that hold our muscles together. So we're going to talk about the epimysium, the perimysium, and then the endomysium. All right, so skeletal muscles are going to be individual muscle cells called skeletal muscle fibers, and then they're going to be organized in what are called fascicles. Then there's going to be nerve fibers, connective tissue, all sorts of stuff here. So let's just focus on the three layers of connective tissue here. And each layer is called a mycia, which is why you see epimysium, paramycium like that. The reason this is important is it provides structure to individual muscles, but it also compartmentalizes muscle fibers, and I'll tell you in a moment why that matters. So first we have the epimysium that you can see there at the top. So an individual skeletal muscle has a layer of dense, irregular connective tissue around it called the epimysium. That allows the muscles to contract and move, but then also keep their integrity. So it's very, very important. The other important reason we have this epimysium is that it separates the muscle from all the other tissues and guts and juices that we have in our body in that area. So it allows the muscles to move independently. So that's very, very important. All right, so that is your epimysium, the dense, irregular connective tissue that encases an individual skeletal muscle. So epi means like above or around. Then, as you can see here at the top, a skeletal muscle is going to be organized into bunches of fibers called muscle fascicles. And each of these muscle fascicles is going to have a layer of paramycium around it. The reason this is important, you especially see these on limb muscles, we'll talk about fascicular arrangement and how it impacts how muscles work. But the reason this is really important is Each of these muscle fascicles, this bunch of individual muscle fibers, is going to be controlled by a motor unit, and that's going to allow the nervous system to trigger a specific movement inside of a muscle. Rather than all the muscle fibers needing to contract at the same time, different motor units can tell different parts of the muscle to function depending on what needs to be done. That's why we only have a handful of muscles, but they can do all sorts of complex movements. All right, and then so the epimysium is around the entire muscle. The paramycium surrounds these muscle fascicles, these bundles of muscle fibers, and then we have at the bottom an individual muscle fiber. So each individual muscle fiber is going to be encased in a thin layer of connective tissue. It's collagen plus some reticular fibers. This is going to be called the endomysium. So the endomysium is the protective coating around an individual muscle cell or individual muscle fiber. So inside this endomysium is where you're going to have the extracellular fluid, the fluid that's around these individual muscle cells, and that's going to be where the nutrients and the different things that muscle fibers need are going to be inside of this casing. All right, so all three of those are very important: the epimysium around a muscle, the paramycium around a muscle fascicle, and the endomysium around an individual muscle fiber. But all of them fuse at the end of muscles, so all this connective tissue fuses to form the tendons. Remember that a tendon is what attaches a muscle to a bone. So they have their individual functions, but they all work as a unit at the end to create this really powerful tendon, so that when muscles do contract, they actually can move your bones and cause movement. All right, those are the three layers of connective tissue involved in skeletal muscles. I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.